diabetes throughout your body causes trouble by damaging your blood vessels. It's a bit like having a house with hard water. Eventually, it chalks up your pipes.
In the beginning, patients don't even know that something is wrong with their body, but diabetes does a lot of damage over time to pretty much all the organs, including your eyes. Diabetes causes what we call diabetic retinopathy, which is basically just diabetic eye disease.
Diabetes is one of the leading causes of permanent blindness in the United States. And to think about that, that means that when you lose vision from diabetes, that's permanent loss that's not restored with glasses or contact lenses or LASIK. And diabetes attacks the small, tiny blood vessels that supply the retina.
And once they're damaged, they don't function well. They can become leaky, which causes the swelling.
And then if enough of your blood vessels become obstructed, you try to grow new blood vessels to account for that. But those new blood vessels are never good. New blood vessel growth in the eye is always bad.
Left untreated, those blood vessels can cause scar tissue to form on the surface of the retina. And that scar tissue can shrink or contract and detach the retina. And those are particularly challenging cases to operate on. The medications we have the ability to kind of tighten those junctions in the blood vessels so that they don't leak, so that the swelling goes down and vision improves.
We've been able to use anti-VEGF agents, which are injected painlessly in the eye, to treat diabetic macular edema and abnormal blood vessel growth. Instead of just preserving vision, in many cases we can improve vision for patients who suffer from severe diabetic eye disease.
The only way to identify these problems sometimes before they become much larger problems is to have regular eye care. Both a dilated exam and photographs is key to this.
Optometrists and ophthalmologists are trained to recognize the signs of diabetic retinopathy and to refer those appropriately.